environment has always been here, and human activity has had a big impact on the environment and has degraded many aspects of it, including our streams and the habitat for anadromous fish. Certainly, you know, we used to have runs of millions of salmon, hence the name of the river and the town, and now we're reduced to a tiny fraction of what we had historically. So we feel a responsibility of at least preserving what we have, but hopefully increasing it and restoring it to a small part of its previous natural state.
We believe that, you know, we can make our backyard better and improve the condition of these fish as they go out. And this is not the only project. There are hundreds of projects that have or are planned to be implemented. You know, and collectively, we believe it's going to make a difference.
And so I appreciate these kind of projects because now they allow the fish to regenerate, go to the ocean, come back, and I think we're getting more fish in the river. I know they aren't out in our bank in our fields anymore, and that for me that's important.
A lot of these tributaries that, like our salmon and steelhead return to, have been negatively impacted by land use things like timber harvest, road building, agriculture, those kinds of things. And it's reduced the amount of quality habitat that's available in these streams. And so the idea here is that we go into these areas and try to improve the habitat and increase the amount of habitat that's available to these fish so that we can produce more fish ultimately.
The majority of my projects are in anadromous waters, which are where salmon and steelhead return, and that's just because that's the funding source is the highest in those areas. But I've worked all the way up in Bonner's Ferry in North Idaho on the Canadian border, all the way down to the Bear Lake drainage.
By improving the habitat, we can actually increase the capacity of that habitat to improve, you know, the number or increase the number of fish that these tributaries produce.
You know, a lot of Idaho habitat, well, we're in the west here, a lot of it's either been hydraulically mined or irrigation withdrawals, big ranches, and so the biologists know what they're faced with when they call me in, and they have a pretty good idea of what we need if, say, a stream channel's been completely diked and we need some side channels, if we need that, you know, winter rearing habitat, then they feed that information to me, and then I help create it working with the natural topography and the stream and the hydraulics.
And the money that is available for our restoration work is directed at salmon and steelhead. However, we know that these actions are going to benefit all species. And so even though we're working on private lands, I would argue is that we're still improving condition and improving numbers for some of our resident fish, such as cutthroat and rainbow, that are available to anglers in the tributaries.
You know, the two biggest areas we work on are in the Clearwater and salmon drainages because of the amount of funding that's available for anadromous fish. But we do have opportunities like in the Panhandle region to improve habitat for West Slope cutthroat and bull trout. And we also have opportunities in the Southeast state pretty regularly where we work on Yellowstone and Bonneville cutthroat and work on improving the habitat available to those trout species.
We seek out federal grants and contracts to improve habitat in Idaho. Our primary funding sources are from NOAA Fisheries, and it's the Pacific Coastal Salmon Recovery Fund and the Bonneville Power Administration. We also work with Fish and Wildlife Service as well. OSC, after seeking the funds, works with local partners, sister agencies, non-governmental organizations, and federal partners to identify and prioritize those habitat projects that will be most impactful.
We want as many fish out in as good a condition as possible for each female salmon and steel that comes back to this basin. And so to do that, we need to address the capacity issue, improve the conditions so they can grow and survive to the best of their ability.
We get to identify where important areas are for rearing of juvenile fish, spawning, habitats, those types of things. And we try to let the fish tell us where we should be focused in our habitat work.
So we're interested in the distribution, the composition of fish, productivity, production, how many fish are they producing, are those fish surviving, are they making it out of the limhi, and will they return? So we'll relate our fish population estimates, our densities, our abundance that we collect to that creek to see how well our populations are doing and what our habitat restoration efforts have helped us with.
Let's effectively monitor those actions, but then also let's also develop tools and products that we can apply to other areas. That was the big picture of the monitoring. It's really, really exciting to see what we've done on the ground, have good solid science behind post-implementation to say this is what the response we see, and maybe this is a response we haven't seen. We've got some big projects now, we're trying to develop some more. The challenge is going to be at this scale, trying to find others out there that's really going to make a difference to those life stages. And stay tuned, we'll see what happens.
It would be impossible without having partners. We have to have the landowners, we have to have the people that are providing the money. It's a big team, and we do need community support, and we need local contractors.
Given the current status of a lot of the habitat that these fish use for spawning and rearing, there is a lot of potential there to increase the numbers of juvenile fish that Idaho produces. And this should mean better fishing in the future, better populations, and hopefully an opportunity to have our kids and our grandchildren get an opportunity to enjoy these fish.
We all want to make a living and keep the ranching business vibrant because it is a big part of the local community, but we also have a responsibility to do what we can to improve the habitat for fish and wildlife.
The salmon, the returns, having them as a part of our state it's part of our way of life, and so I guess I just wanted to have a part in that.